So I'm going on a trip to the Muriwai coastline today, and I'm going to be investigating how it was developed through a series of investigations such as longshore drift and sand movement counting. I'm really excited for this trip. I'm really grateful that CGA has given me this opportunity. I think it's a really, really cool time for me to go and do such a thing, especially because I'm almost finishing school now and I can take this with me when I go to university and things, and I think it's going to be really, really helpful. Hi, my name is Gemma. I'm from Pocono, south of Auckland, and I'm a CGA student.
Hi, my name is Vanessa, and I'm teaching AS Geography.
We'll collect one type of data at each location then to give you an idea of how it is collected.
So we are at Muriwai Beach, and today we're looking at coastal processes, so how the wave processes are affecting the physical structure of dunes and sediment budgets on this beach. We collected a variety of data using different methods. So we started off with a beach profile, and that's where you would have seen the 2 1-metre rollers, the tape measure and the clinometer, and that's where we're measuring the angle of the beach between each of these points, and that way we can build that up using some maths or trigonometry, and we can see how steep the beach is when we get back into the classroom.
24. I got 4. 2. 4.
We also did a longshore drift, so that's where we can see the zigzag motion of the water and the current dragging sediment up and taking it away again, and that way we can see which end of the beach is likely to be built up over time and eroded, and it gives us a bit of an idea of what's going to happen in the future. Normally we would use oranges as a flotation device to see the movement of the current up and down the beach, but the oranges, you throw them in a couple of times and they disintegrate, so you have to buy more oranges. They're really expensive. So I found a rubber duck and I managed to secure a rope to the back of it just to give it a little bit more weight, and that floats really well.
Yeah.
That sort of information is used in council planning in terms of preparing and building seawalls and whatnot. We also did, we got some climate data just to see how that's going to impact things, and we did a wave count as well, just to get a bit of an idea about how powerful the waves are today.
Yeah, I study A-levels, so I do geography, chemistry, biology and English literature. I really enjoy geography. You get to do a lot of cool things like field trips, and it's a combination of English and biology and chemistry, so it's really great. I really like how it's working on real world problems, so I do a lot of work into other countries and how we can actually fix things that are happening to the world right now.
I got to do a lot of in-depth research, which I just wouldn't get to do in an ordinary classroom, and it was all tailored to me, so if I found something really interesting then we'd spend a whole lesson just looking at that topic.
I focused mainly on the sand dunes, so I did a lot of research into their threats, how they developed, and I did a lot of work on how the waves influence the sand movement and things like that. I think because you do most of your learning online, you get that time to really focus on it. We did a lot of planning. There was a lot of watching lots of interactive videos. I did a lot of my own research and getting secondary data, which was really great to base my research questions on. And then you can come out and meet everyone and have that social aspect and really put what you learned into action. And I think it's really, really great, and I enjoy it a lot. It's been a real good adventure.